Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Hidden Genius Project's 2022 end-of-the-year celebration for our Bay Area geniuses. Now, I will be your host for today. My name is Guy Heston Parrish, and I am from Cohort Oak 7. Now, the geniuses inside waiting for you, they have been working tirelessly day and night for 7 weeks straight to show you guys what they have learned over the summer. So how about let's hop into it? Let's get started. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. So as you guys follow me, this is the main room. You can see it's highly populated. A lot of exciting energy in here. Very, very excited. So the geniuses are just ahead. Just ahead. Okay, so if you could just say your name and your cohort and then talk about your website.
Okay, my name is Nathaniel and my cohort is OAK10 Black. And my website is called Cuts on the Go. And we're basically a mobile barbershopping app that allows you to schedule appointments at the barber or like if they want to come to your house. So I thought of this idea because like I needed a haircut, guys, and like what better idea than like schedule an appointment with an app. So that
Feel you. That's crazy because I just got my haircut yesterday. My barber was tripping. He was booked. So I had to get my cut actually early this morning, like 5 something. So that's crazy, bro. I'm going to need it. Thank you, bro. But say your name one time and you're a cohort.
My name is Nathaniel, and this is my cohort, OAK10 Black.
So if you are in need of haircuts, Nathaniel, that is our guy. That is your guy. I'll be into a little bit about what your ideation process was behind this. So, like, get really into the meat of why did I want to make this and how it benefits other people.
Yeah, for sure. So basically, I felt that this my website was missing in the community. People, it's really hard for people to actually go out and seek someone to buy and trade. So I thought acting as a middleman, make it easy. Everyone comes to me. Of course, I get like a tiny cut of the profits to make money. It was something that people, well, as someone who's actually in the community, I felt that it was missing. And I thought I'll be the perfect person to go out and actually create the thing. Yeah, the website.
That's really cool, my guy. That's
OAK10 Black.
So that is Jude Pignon. Can we just show some love to all the geniuses, all the cool products? So I want to see a bunch of hearts in the chats, 100 emojis in the chats. Whatever emoji is your favorite, drop it in the chat real quick for us. So let's move on. Soccer, so I might need to use your website one of these days. But thank you, Lucas. Thank you. So that was our very own Lucas from Oakland 10, cohort Oakland 10. Hi, hello. Excuse me. I guess we'll move on. What's up, my brother? Do you have your website up? Okay, well, what's your name?
My name's Omari.
Say it one more time.
My name's Omari.
Okay, for sure, Omari. So can you show us what your website is about?
Well, man,
so can you tell us what are some of the coding languages that you use to actually build your website?
Yeah, so I use things like JavaScript, HTML, CSS, stuff like that.
And so just for our viewers out there who don't really know what HTML, CSS, or JavaScript is, can you give them a brief description on what those coding languages do?
So JavaScript, I say, is more of like the functionality part where like it kind of like drives it. Like when you click on something, like JavaScript is the thing that like takes it to the actual website. Now CSS, what I would say is...
And what we did over the summer at Hidden Genius Project in Richmond, so...
Heard you.
I'm an actor. I've been acting since I was like 10 years old, and you know I've acted at many theaters and many places. So, but at the Hidden Genius, we did a couple projects where we designed our own version of the Pac-Man game. Yeah, and we chatbot, you know, where you can like type into the computer and it will give you a response. Yeah. And then we also did a couple classes where they would teach you how to be teach you some good life skills, you know, like how to tie a tie or how to write a good email to your boss or something like that. Yeah. And it also did another class where it's called RSC, and they teach you how to be a very good entrepreneur. So, you know, it's a really good project, a really good program for, you know, Black.
Word. So overall, you said the Hidden Genius Project has really helped you develop yourself.
For sure. Yeah, it's totally helped me out in how to be a better male in the world.
Along with the Hidden Genius Project, feel free to donate at hiddengeniusproject.org/donate.
Hey, Jesus, already? All right, let's do our mission statement. Who are we?
Hidden Genius Project.
Let's get started.
Thank you, Jesus. Now, I would like to bring up Rich Five's very own Jordan Steen Rice.
My clothing brand is Street Athleisure, and I provide comfortable and alluring athletic apparel. And some may ask, why not Nike or Adidas? And I feel as if I separate myself from Nike and other sportswear clothing, because not only am I making sportswear, but we also are a streetwear clothing brand. And and certified boards prioritize comfort but never compromise on streetwear safety. And a question I get a lot is, what does certified really mean? My definition of certified really means just being the best at whatever you do, whether it's school, sports, or even the job you work at. And then here's some of my clothing designs.
Customer base, this would mean you have a 55% customer retention rate. Now, time to conversion. This one's personally my favorite because time to conversion describes the amount of time leads usually take to make a purchase. So say it's too long, right? They'd be like, well, the price is so low, it could be a scam. Or say it's taking too long, the price could be too high. Oh, wow, this is definitely not worth it, right? So we gotta make sure our prices are right there, perfect. Next slide, please. Now, our value propositions. We hope photographers have a successful outlet to express themselves to their communities by giving them a snippet, by giving them a page on Snapchat where they can post their work. We also help photographers get recognition for the work by helping them start and maintain a flawless Snapchat online portfolio. Finally, we help photographers use our platform to communicate using photography by allowing them and their peers to discuss what their photo represents. Next slide. What do we provide? Like I've been saying, access to a portfolio on our platform, along with access to an online account with Snapchat, guidance to a flawless Snapchat portfolio. We also give you recognition right from the Snapchat community with likes, comments, and shares. Access to education on how to communicate through photography, and that education part will come back next slide, I believe. Access to discussions about what a photo represents through section comments. Next slide. This is our team. Abraham Carletta, he's our website developer, right? He's an educator for the Hidden Genius Project and web developer with experience building and designing mobile apps. And I'm Joseph Johnson, CEO / photographer. I'm a young black male photographer and a mentor to my black community. Next slide. Our vision, so say 10 years from now, our vision is to introduce lots of unfamiliar faces to the photography industry and enable successful photographers to give back to the Snapchat community by helping upcoming photographers get recognition. Next slide. Thank you.
Now I want to give you a peek into the technology creation part of our program. Now I get to introduce you all to my brothers from my own site, BJ, Yafet, and Sione.
interacting with my site and some of the features. It's kind of long.
My name is Yafe Jonas, and I'm from the Orange 5. Next slide. My final project is a self-driving AI car that works on a simulator. Over the Hidden Genius project, my main idea was to do something with robotics. Along the way, AI became something I thought I could combine with it. That is why I decided to make a self-driving car. Over this summer, I mostly worked with AI, and I was able to finish it. But the robotics portion is a work in progress. This is a little, can we go back? Yeah, this is a little demo of like my project. Next slide. When I first got into my final project, I had to work with teaching an AI, how to identify lane lines on the side of roads. After that, I worked on having it be able to differentiate between different numbers. And the last step before working on the actual car was having it predict road signs. Next slide. By teaching the AI to know not to cross the lane lines, it is able to drive on the simulated roads of completely new places without crashing. The car is in the simulator has cameras around the car that tell the car its surroundings. The data from the cameras run through some code that outputs a steering angle for the car to follow, demonstrated on the bottom slide. Next slide. As AI proceeds, it will be possible to create accident-free roads. As of now, self-driving cars are not perfect, but even now, cars that are able to self-brake are very helpful. Accidents are a very normal thing, but with complete AI-assisted driving, this will reduce it significantly. Next slide. I plan to continue with the AI car, but more on the robotic side. I've started working with microcontrollers in order to apply my AI code into a real mini vehicle. AI mixed with robotics is what I had aimed for since the beginning of this program, and now I'm able to, and now I am starting to fulfill it. Thank you.
proposing this evening and give them an opportunity to confirm. There is no. Challenges that we face, though,
was the work ethic, trying to show up and want to do the work. But that didn't stop us. We kept pushing, we kept telling our brothers, do the work, and that's exactly what they did. They kept moving, we got through it. All right? Now, some other problems that we faced was the lack of communication going towards the middle of the program. Well, we got over that as well. We learned how to talk to each other. We did it. That's what we did. That's my experience for the Hidden Genius Project of 2022. All right? Now, thank you for your time. And I'm glad I could have brought this message to all of you here today.
Good evening. My name is Isaiah Wilson. I'm from Ridge 5, and I'm
I'm 16 years old. My experience in the Hidden Genius Project was really fun and exciting. I was able to learn coding, different terms like HTML, CSS, and I had the opportunity to go on business trips to BlackRock, where I learned about investments and risk management solutions. I was able to make relationships with not just my educator and mentor, but also with other Hidden Genius brothers, which I now have a connection with till this day. I really appreciate the support from David, Perry, Casey, and the YEs, because without them, I'm not able to learn or understand anything they were teaching me. I appreciate the real-world issues and problems the Hidden Genius program introduced to me, things like the government and the right to limit abortions, and other things in the world that we need to know. They taught me how to maintain myself in front of people and how to carry myself through situations that I will use when I'm older. I appreciate the educators holding me accountable and making sure I don't lack in work and giving me chances to prove that I can do what I put my mind to. And I appreciate the homely feeling that was in the atmosphere, especially from the other geniuses, because I feel like that was needed for us to be comfortable. I enjoyed the connections I had with everyone and for welcoming me like I was their own. Hidden Genius is a great role model and choice that I have to grow as a person, and I thank them for what they gave me. Hi, my name is Isaac Wilson. I'm from Risk 6, I'm 16, and my experience in the Hidden Genius Project was one to remember because I met new friends that helped me throughout the program. I learned coding, which wasn't easy for me at first, but with the help of my group, David, my resilience, persistence, and dedication to the program and the YEs, I caught on to it pretty well. I just want to thank David and my brother, because without David, I feel like I wouldn't have gotten as far as I did. I want to thank my brother because without him, I wouldn't have joined or had any motive to come. Creating a brotherhood with the other geniuses, I feel like was needed because not only is it good energy, but it's someone close to age and no one is judgmental. So you can connect to them in a different way that you couldn't connect with an adult, like if you know what I'm saying. Some memories that I loved throughout the summer was beating everyone in basketball, going to Wings after program with my brothers, going on inspirational business trips, and just connecting with everyone in the program. I want to thank Casey because she kept me on my toes, held me accountable, made sure I got my work done, and was just someone there when you needed her. I'd like to congratulate my brothers in Rich 5 on their journey of completion of the hard work that they put into developing their code. And when you guys come back to BYE, she'll probably get better at basketball again. Thank you.
Thank you, Isaac and Isaiah, for representing Rich 5 and Rich 6 so well. Let us hear it from Christian 5. Christian Rich 5.
Good evening. My name is Christian White, and I'm a part of the Rich 5 cohort. I'm from Richmond, California, and currently attend El Cerrito High School as a senior. Being a young genius at the Hidden Genius has been a great experience for me, and I really appreciate the opportunity that was given to me. Having the chance to learn technology, coding, entrepreneurship, and business skills will serve me well in the future and years to come. I also enjoy visiting the tech and business companies, such as Switch, Nextracker, BlackRock, and learning about the different career paths in tech and business streets. Most importantly, I value the brotherhood and the bonds I made with my brothers and Hingies, including the wives and staff as well. Thank you for investing in me. Although at first it was challenging for me to commit to Hingies' schedule because I'm also an athlete, the Hingies project helped me with time management and improved my communication skills in a lot of ways. As I mentioned, I am a student athlete and I love sports. So of course, my final project has to be sports related. So I created a website called Sports Talk. Sports Talk is a website that people can look at on the daily for about 3 to 10 minutes and get all the information on they need to know. My website, Sports Talk, is here to help the day-to-day fan understand sports in a clear light, showcasing different athletes, their abilities, accomplishments through sport, and the impact they have on others. Without this village around me, none of this would be possible. I really appreciate the impact the Hidden Genius Project has had on me and all my others. Thank you.
Thank you, Christian. Now I'd like to bring up Camo, Trevor, and Anthony up on the stage.
Hey everybody, how y'all doing? Can y'all believe this? 10 years? Come on now, congratulations to that. Congratulations to the brothers, you know what I'm saying? Well, before I start anything, I would like to say my name is Anthony Chisholm Jr. I'm representing OAK9 Gold, one of the best, you know, they may argue different, but one of the best cohorts that there is. And I am currently in 11th grade, and I go to Crystal Ray De La Salle and stay high school, so that's where I go. So thank you. One of the things that I want to touch upon right now is throughout Hidden Genius, there has been a lot of different things that Hidden Genius has taught me. That can be through communication, education, leadership skills, which is something that I really want to touch upon. Leadership. Leadership is something that anybody can do, but you might have to have the right person in order to teach you. That comes in Hidden Genius. They taught me a lot of different things with leadership, especially coming up here right now, talking in front of you guys. That's something that a leader would be able to do. But one of the main things that I wanted to touch upon that is that leadership, as I said, can help you with presentations, can help you speak in front of large crowds, and even with interviews. Interviews can be scary, but you gotta be able to have that leadership skill in order to, you know, pick yourself up and be able to do it. But, you know, that's just one of the things that I would say that, you know, has helped me. But I want to pass it on to one of my great brothers here. Yeah. He's gonna talk about the other aspects of Hidden Genius.
What's up, everyone? I'm Keegan Smith. I'm from OAK9 Black and alumni of the Hidden Genius Project. Today I want to talk about how entrepreneurship changed me for the better. I was always fond of technology ever since I was a little kid. And ever since now, when I came to Hidden Genius, I was looking for opportunities to use technology to create scalable solutions to solve disparities in my communities. With the Hidden Genius Project, they gave me mentors to help discuss and further create my idea of how my business is going to be ran. My business is around environmentally friendly products, so I posted the e-commerce websites and mobile app. With the Hidden Genius Project, I was able to create scalable solutions to solve disparities in my community and create community. And I want to just show a quick showcase of how my app goes. So you can just register, and then once you go to the homepage, your account. Yeah, we get to the homepage, you're welcome, and we have a showcase of all our environmentally friendly products. And we also view products and be able to buy them. So with this solution in mind, I want to be able to solve disparities in my community as well as bring unity in my community, because this is a platform to express whatever you want. And speaking of unity, we also have brotherhood. So I'm going to pass it to my brother, Trevor Walton.
What's up, everyone? My name is Trevor Walton. I'm part of the OAK9 Gold cohort, as my man Anthony said, one of the best cohorts, you know. I'm in St. Mary's College High School in the sophomore. And I just want to reiterate what we said about community, but we also talked about leadership. We talked about entrepreneurship. Hidden Genius was not just a class. We also had the opportunity to play basketball with our homies and just go out and just play. No matter who won, no matter who looked, we all just came together and said, hey man, good job, hey, nice three-pointer, hey, nice layup. It was just the idea that we're able to be together as a group that just made it possible, that just added on to the community standpoint, to the idea of brotherhood. and not just basketball. It was just the idea that we were able to go together and make music. I know my man Anthony was spinning some bars in the music room while we were there in the Hidden Genius Project. And during that time, even though some of us weren't there, that still reiterated why we all came together, that we were all a brotherhood. We all had each other's backs. We were all able to be like family, have a stronger bond. And during the time, we developed that bond to make sure we could get stronger all the way to the end of the 12 weeks. And I'm really happy I was able to create a brotherhood with my boys over here, everyone over here. And I'm just so happy that we can continue this heritage, and as the new cohorts come, the new cohorts thrive, we're able to know that I have hope that they'll continue that brotherhood and continue that legacy, just remembering I am my brother's keeper. Thank you all. Thank you.
Project for your enjoyment. Thank you. Appreciate it. Good evening, everybody.
What up? Yeah.
Have you enjoyed yourself this evening? I hope so. A lot of us felt nervous just hanging out together, right? You know, like, I hope all these chairs are 6 feet apart. They're not, right? But imagine how nervous these young men must have felt, right, having been at the same front. So can we give them a big round of applause? My name is Brandon Richardson. I'm Executive Director of the Hidden Genius Project, and I'll be happy to share a few more words just a bit later. But we did want to acknowledge some of the tremendous efforts of our young people. First off, just shout out to everyone who supported our young people, our families, and our parents. You know, having our geniuses come back in person this year was tough. So everybody really is a Bob Lemon Prize winner. But we have created the Bobby Eugene Lemon Prize Award in honor of one of our senior innovation educators, Bobby Eugene Lemon, who is very much the godfather in the space of computer science education and advocacy. He has a tremendous story, rags to riches, to rags back to riches again. Bobby has traveled the world and has such a big heart for young people. So big that he doesn't have any heart left for adults, and he gets the rest of his all the time. But we want to give him his flowers while he's here, so every year now we honor, now at each site, a genius with an award for an outstanding technology project. And so for Richmond, there was a young man we saw this evening who put his foot in his hat, as we like to say, and we will bring that back up one time. I don't think he knows, but this young person did present, challenged himself to move into an emerging technology space. He's got big dreams, and you may remember he did an artificial intelligence project. He can't wait to show me his robot. But yeah, Fred, robot, we're in the building. And you know, like, you let that go, James. We gotta wait, where did it go? Because we need to transition over to that slide up. Can we do with that slide up? Can we actually do the digital dance again? Is that okay? I bet we didn't get the check. This is your check right here. Thank you.
The Hidden Genius Project really changed my life, and it allowed me to delve into places I never thought I wanted to go into, right? My project, the AI, never thought before the Hidden Genius Project. So I'd just like to thank them, all my people in the Hidden Genius Project, you know, my cohort, Rich Bob, best cohort. David, of course, Terry, and everyone else who helped me along the way. So, thank you.
So, before we announce the next one, did anybody else observe, or you saw Yaakov present about 26 minutes ago?
Yeah.
I don't know who this was just now. He got that money, started burning. So, I like to send a shout out to my cousin. Everybody back home, shout out to my boys, because we're going to shout out. That's crazy. That's unbelievable. You're like, yeah, I won that. You already know. So we have the young man who is not here today. He's the winner of the Oakland Bob Lemon Award Prize. He is named Mark Gaston. And if we say he put his foot in his app, I think he put just a whole, he got into his kneecaps. He developed a game utilizing the Unity platform that operates, I don't even want to ruin it by describing it. We're going to show you his sizzle reel, and then we'll just say a couple more things about it. But without further ado, Mark Gaston's game.
Thank you.
Record. Here's my time at the Hidden Genius Project. I was mainly focused on game design. And sadly, I wasn't able to make it out to the end of summer celebration. But I was able to put together this video for you about my game that I made called The Complex. Let's start off with a simple explanation of the game. The Complex is an ever-before-explored dimension outside of reality. Divided by different laws and norms, and you can get there by accidentally falling to this world. This dimension is called the Backrooms. In my game, your specific goal is to escape the Backrooms dimension. The Backrooms have originated from a post several years ago on a website called 4chan that had a mysterious image and a bit of text. The only problem is, to this day, we haven't been able to find the origin of this image, leading some to speculate about whether or not the Backrooms are actually real. There's a twist in my game that makes it stand out way more than the other Backrooms games in the community. I created 6 separate endings to my game, and escaping the Backrooms alive is only one of them. There's also a secret 7th ending that can only be obtained after you play the game at least once. The target audience of my game, The Complex, are people that are interested in horror games, those that are at least somewhat interested in solving puzzles, and those in the expected age range of 8 to 42 years old. Throughout the game, you're being led by an underground organization called MEG. They leave several books behind that teach you how to survive in a complex. However, you soon find out that MEG has been leading you to your demise the entire time. It's also important to note that in this game, I played a lot with illusions and something called a non-Euclidean geometry. By making use of these two things, I can trick the player's mind into believing that they're walking through a doorway into a house, only to find out that the doorway disappeared behind them. This illusionary trick works best when this YouTuber on YouTube thought he had escaped the Backrooms, only to find out that he willingly walked right back into it, and the so-called doorway disappeared behind him. Here's the clip. While I was making this game, there were a lot of times where I had to literally predict what a player would look behind them, what direction a player would go in, and how a player would react in a tight situation. This is just a fraction of how much psychological info went into making The Complex. The last thing I want to say is that this game is available on a very massive game distribution platform called itch.io for your 64 code. However, I've only created builds for Mac, Windows, and Linux, and this game is not available on mobile or VR. Alright, Genius, thanks very much for watching. This has been The Complex. I'm Mark Gaskin.
I think we know who won. Everybody does great. Upside, y'all. Now, I mean, look, the boy got 7 alternate endings, so come on, man. You said you were out, but you were in, but you were out. So he, Mark and his family, were going through so much. He and his family ended up moving to Georgia, to the Atlanta area. And they were able to arrange for Mark to stay with the loved ones. And as you can see, Mark did not waste a moment of his time. He did his work well. But he is now the Oakland winner of the Bob Milligan Prize. Mark has asked me to let you all know if you or your loved ones would like to get tutorials in game development. Follow his YouTube handle, Developer Chick, on YouTube. He has videos. You can also contact him there, and he's willing to set something up for you. And I don't know if you caught it or not, but Mark was able to get his game on platform already. And so you can certainly find some to go. I know that QR code went really fast, but again, it's on YouTube, so you can go check it out. So can we give a round of applause? In fact, I don't know if Mark is watching right now. It's about 11, 7 o'clock in Atlanta, but I'm sure he'll see the recording. So my man who, hung tough for 7 more weeks without his family just so he could build this and win is back in Atlanta. Can y'all show him a little love back home? So we are so close, but we always want to hear from at least one family member before we leave. So I have the distinct pleasure to introduce Ms. Leah, who is mother of Jirai, and she also happens to be Chief Marketing Development and Technology Officer at Star Vista. She's here to share a few words about her experience and her son's experience in the Hidden Genius Project. Ms. Leah?
Hi, I wasn't nervous coming in, but I think you guys are amazing. You all have managed to make me very nervous. I'm not sure how to follow all that. Thank you for introducing me. My name is Leah Rahane. I'm the parent of Jeffrey Filan. I also have my two daughters with me, Mele and Layla. They are 12th and 10th graders here in Oakland. And my son is a freshman at Boston University, and he completed this program last year. So I've lived in the Bay Area since I immigrated to the United States at age 9. Immigrating to America and adapting to a new world came with some confusion and lots of questions for me. But this experience has helped me to deeply understand the need for perseverance, human support, and community at a very young age. To chase the American dream, unfortunately, the cities where we have chosen to live and the schools where we have chosen to send our children have not been diverse. My son was actually the only Black male in his class from 9th to 12th grade. So for me, programs like the Hidden Genius are a co-parent. They're not just a program. Black community programs like the Hidden Genius program that are designed by us, for us, are critical in helping me raise my children. My son, Jeff Bryan, has had the privilege of being part of the Richmond cohort. He claims it's the best, too. And he did it for 15 months. Unfortunately, he did it through the pandemic. My surprise was, I thought, is he going to be uninterested? Is he going to stop? Is he really going to do this? And despite his 15-month experience being remote through the pandemic, he remained committed and engaged. The program staff were all relatable, warm, and supportive. A Hidden Genius program instructor, Jamal, came all the way to our home to welcome him to the program and drop off a laptop so that he would be able to do all of the work that the Hidden Genius program was doing, because his laptop was an older version that wasn't able to keep up with the stuff that they were doing. Just watching all of this was just warming my heart. As a mother that is raising a Black son, my heart warmed up every time I heard the instructors and mentors introduce each other. It was always, brother such and such, what do you have to say? Brother such and such, what do you have to add? You know, I'm doing my work as we're all at home, it's the pandemic, but that would warm my heart up a little bit too. So in addition to that, you know, I'd walk by my son and see all the little squares full of young Black men, and they're all engaged. They're talking about coding. They're talking about business opportunities, social good. I was inspired. I was inspired to do something. I was inspired to put my girls in similar programs. I also witnessed the pride of my son that he felt every time he got a check. He just loved opening them. He didn't cash them. He just loved opening them. He actually really didn't cash them. But it helped him stay on top of his work. Receiving these payments also demonstrated his time was valuable and that the program valued him and valued his time. He gained a better understanding of his work. In addition, he enhanced his time management skills and his ability to advocate for himself through opportunities created by office hours. He never missed office hours. He's like, oh mom, I gotta put my office hours. Let's do this. He said, no, I'm gonna miss out on my money. So he, you know, that kept him engaged. This sense of advocacy helped build a really tremendous mentor and mentee relationship between John Wright and Arnold, one of the counselors. Arnold used to help John Wright think through his summer commitments because he didn't want to miss out on Hidden Genius. He ended up getting a summer internship opportunity with Harvard, and he was really considering not doing it. And then he decided to speak with Arnold, and Arnold helped him figure out his schedule so that he could do both. So he didn't miss out on Hidden Genius, and he didn't miss out on that other program either. He also continued to help Jacques balance doing his work for the program and doing other things so that he wasn't limited to just doing that. He continues to build a rapport with him, and eventually Arnold nominated him for a Posse Scholar program. Jacques actually had the conviction and comfort to actually ask Arnold to nominate him. He felt like he had his back that much, although he had counselors at schools that he could have worked with. So once this summer passed, he applied for this scholarship. This really Arnold nominated him. He went through a very gruesome process. About 15,000 students that compete for this scholarship. And out of those 15,000, 660 win the scholarship for 60 schools throughout the United States. So this is a leadership merit-based scholarship. It is for 4 years of tuition. And John Wright did become a Posse Scholar. He is attending Boston University with a full-term tuition scholarship. And I'm really proud that Hidden Genius played a role in that. You know, we can never take away that Arnold is the person that nominated him. He has the scholarship because of that. He worked out his schedule. He also, to his credit, he utilized the opportunities that were there for him. The office hours, the mentorship. So I really encourage all of you to do that as well. So once Jeffrey got his scholarship announcement, in this order is how it went. He told me, he told his sisters, then he called Arnold, then he told his school. So it was really a beautiful thing to see how excited Arnold was. You would think it was his own little brother or his son or something, and he really congratulated him. He also sent him a BU sweatshirt. Arnold is now at Harvard, and he continues to mentor my son, who's in Boston as well. And they continue to have this mentee-mentor relationship. My son also contacted him. Genius. He plans to come back and be a youth educator. He wants to go back to Richmond or Oakland. That's his intention right now. So I'm extremely thankful that my son had an opportunity to be part of the Hidden Genius Project. I really urge all of you to support the dream of the Hidden Genius Project, which is to connect Black males with the skills, mentors, and experiences they, our children, need to become high-performing entrepreneurs and technologists in the 21st century global economy. Thinking about the current racial injustices in our country, we all know it is so, so, so important to support organizations like Hidden Genius. I can't say that enough. I really do feel like you guys partnered with me, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart, all of you. I'd just like to close with saying, if you believe in an equitable world, it is imperative to support programs like the Hidden Genius Program. Support financially, and if it's not you, we all forget that we work somewhere or we're self-employed. I didn't used to know this, but if you bank somewhere, they can be a sponsor. If you shop somewhere, they can be a sponsor. If you work at Facebook, wherever you are, you can be a champion, and it looks good on you. You end up being the leader as well. You're leading them to invest in you and your child. They'd love to do that. You're creating an opportunity, and this is a space that all organizations are trying to make a difference in right now. It's a huge DEI effort. So I encourage anybody that doesn't feel like they have a role to play, you have a big role to play, and there's space for all of us. Thank you.
You know, you came, hopefully you got to see some of the projects, hopefully you got a snack, something to eat, hopefully you got to talk to a couple geniuses, you know, hopefully now you understand why we look so tired all the time. We're extremely proud of these young men, so I want to definitely offer some thank yous, you know, first and foremost, of course, to the organizations and entities that helped make this possible, our sponsors, Alves and Kaiser Permanente Road Foundation. But then, of course, I want to thank all the geniuses who made it through the day. And shout out to them for that. For those of you geniuses that are left, I hope you'll definitely give it up for your families right now, your parents, your guardians, all the girls you love. Also want to send a shout out, of course, because we are here celebrating cohorts OAK9 Gold, OAK9 Black, OAK10 Gold, OAK10 Black, Rich 5, Rich 6. And if you wonder about the gold and the black, that's because while we were sleeping, right, in 2019, some of you were at the Rotunda with us at our summer celebration, and some of you joined virtually for the next 2 years. And during that time, we actually doubled with the number of cohorts we could serve in Oakland alone. So now one's called Black, one's called Gold every year. So that's huge. But I also want to send a shout out to our young men at Oak 7 and Rich 3, and Oak 8 and Rich 4 in particular, because those guys are, you know, super resilient. And some of them I know are here today helping us out. But you're talking about, you heard a story about a young man like John Wright, right? Who started and ended virtually, you know? So as hard as it is to do this for 15 months period, these young men had to do it in squares, boxes, breakout rooms, stuck on mute, videos off, you know, looping gifts in the back, so it looks like they're there, but they're really not, you know, all the things. And some of the innovation we saw was quite spectacular. Where these young people find ways to avoid actually having to. And if they would have put that effort, right? Bro, you just sat there and just didn't work. But that's for, we don't have time for all that. But just so you know, so appreciative and proud of those young people and how resilient they are. We don't want them to have to be this resilient all the time, right? We want them to be able to be children and have fun, experience joy. But we are so proud that they are and were. And then, of course, that so many of them would then come back and be educators and mentor their brothers, as you heard. Definitely want to appreciate our staff. And can our staff wave their hands wherever you might be? Keep hearing those things. Our students, our educators, our folks who work, our admin, central teams, our folks at each site. Even, you know, we have even our Los Angeles site director, Kayla Mason, with supporting. So there's so many different people that have to chip in every single day. And especially when we were virtual, we really had to support each other and lean on each other. And anybody who saw any of our celebrations for the last couple of years would have seen us basically having one big celebration, right? And all chipped in. We're back at it though this year, so next Tuesday, on live stream for you all here, or for those of you in Los Angeles, want to check it out. Tuesday at 6, right, at Brown Bird in Los Angeles, California. We'll do this again, if you can believe it. And then Saturday, October 8th in Detroit at the Boys and Girls Club on the West Side, we will do this again. That's a lot of celebrating these young people, but I think it's worth it. And we encourage you, because we will live stream each one. So for those of you who are curious and want to brag that you saw them all, we encourage you to check them out. We had some tremendous young people, as it turns out, wherever we go. I think it was Sean, our Director of Strategic Initiatives, who had gone down to our last Los Angeles site for a couple of days and came back and said, yeah, it tastes like our food, right? You know, meaning that, you know, you feel that sense of brotherhood, that sense of connection. You feel the care and passion that our adults, our staff, our volunteers, et cetera, had for our young people. So we're so grateful to be able to do this in multiple places. Extremely grateful for everyone who helped out tonight, our volunteers, but not the least of all, grateful for you all for coming and supporting us, believing in our work. And of course, Ms. Leah said there may be ways you can support. The great news tonight is we do the end of summer celebration that we've been doing it. In fact, is he still here? Jason, are you still here? Jason is networking with that. Jason Young, one of our founding board members, with the very first end of summer celebration, now living in Atlanta. And you know, Jason and our founding core of black men created this amazing tradition that we put on one of the world's worst fundraisers, but one of the world's best friendraisers, right? And there's a little bit of game to this, right? Because there are folks who know how to pass the plate and ask for dollars, and it's great, you can do it for a day. And there's different ways you do that. Usually, you know, you have to, you know, maybe mix up the beverage selection, and you gotta, you know, you gotta heat up the chicken for a little bit longer, maybe have a fish and a steak option. But the thing that keeps you coming back every year, we'll have folks who say, I remember my first in the summer celebration in 2013, then I remember when I finally got promoted to a manager or a director or a VP. I remember the first time that I joined this, you know, fraternity or this organization, and I can finally get them to meet you all. So that's all we ask. You know somebody, right? Who knows somebody who could do something with us? And maybe you and maybe your people. And that's all you need to know for now. If you are super curious, the website is right behind you. You know that? And there's a QR code on one of the other ones. And you can always support us. But the most important thing is that we're still able to do this in our communities, that we need us, you all, to continue to advocate for us and support us, especially as we grow. Keep telling young people that the application is open, even today. They can visit our website. So we thank you in advance for all the tremendous ideas you have to make sure this work can keep going. Finally, I just want to say thank you, of course, to there's one person, actually, who convinced me. I did not want to do this job. And so it was almost 8 years ago when I played with Jason Young and Tom Warren. We had dinner, and they invited me to throw my hat in the ring. And I was working the job where I worked around a lot of executive directors, and they did not seem that happy. So I said, this does not seem like something I should do, right? Because I want to be happy. Okay, I care about our black boys and young men, and even though I don't like them that much, I love them, and I'm here for you, right? I support you, and I think you can make this work. I think you can do some cool stuff. But here's the thing, at the time, we didn't have a budget, right? Nor any real infrastructure, office space, computers, furniture, running water, windows, right? And then I went home, and I was like, hey, I went home and I was talking to my wife and said, hey, guess what? I'm up here to do this job with no money, furniture, computers, windows, running water, etc. And she said, that sounds like a really great idea. You would be sad that you never tried it, right? And if it doesn't work out, you'll figure out something else to do. So on Monday, next Monday, we'll celebrate 12 years of marriage. But the Lord gave me the courage to do it, all right? And our son, Nico, he's going to have a little bit of a night. We've got Terry step up, so I'm super proud of him as well. Great job, Nico. So thankful to you. Thank you, babe. I appreciate you. And so, without further ado, we should all say goodbye. Can we thank our MCs? Can y'all come up? So, next year, we'll have to do it bigger. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to OAK10, Black and Gold, Rich 6. Any final words for good about it?
Thank you for coming to our 11th annual End of Summer Celebration.
Woo!
Jesus. Thank you so much for being a fantastic crowd, listening to us and applauding for us. We appreciate it.
And finally, for these final 3 months of the year, it's going to be a whirlwind for us, for sure. We've got a lot of exciting things ahead, not all of which we can talk about at this very moment. What we would love, though, is if you can follow us, be it on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok. I think we have a Snap somewhere. I don't even do that much on it right now. That's okay, though. Check out our newsletter, etc., and help spread the word. We're going to have some extremely exciting things happening that we're announcing, and we're so excited to reach more young people in more places But tonight was all about Oakland and Richmond. So please get home safely. Please be safe. Please stay healthy. Have a great night. Thank you for coming.